And now we will learn how to track time using time sheets. What are timesheets? Well, timesheets are weekly summaries of time slips and single activity events that we learned about in our previous video. They have the exact same information as time slips. You can enter information exactly the same way as you would with time slips. There are no separate reports for timesheets. Time slips and timesheets go on the same reports, and the results look exactly the same way. You can identify timesheets by week and by worker. You can open up the timesheet window by clicking Customer, Enter Time, Use Weekly Timesheet. Now, it's blank, but even if we choose the workers whom we've entered time for, like Ben the worker, nothing comes up. Or Sharon the worker, nothing comes up. That's because these workers did not work during the week of August 1 to August 7th. But if I leave Sharon the worker selected and I move the date box forward to the week that she did work, that we recorded in our previous video, the week of April 10 is the week of April 10 to April 16. And this was the time slip that we recorded in our previous video. We recorded it on a time slip, but if we put the same worker and week, we can see that time slip or any other time slip listed here on Sharon's timesheet. Same thing with Ben the worker. We have the correct dates, and he did work between these dates. And here's the time slip that we recorded in our previous video. Now, to prove to you that time slips and timesheets are the same thing, we can open up one of the reports and we can double-click right on one of the events and double-click again and go back to the original time slip where that information is entered. Right here in the time slip window, you can click timesheet and you can see where this slip fits in to the weekly timesheet. So they are the same thing, just organized differently, and you have to choose which one you would like to record the worker's time. Now let's try the same thing we did on a time slip in the previous video with timesheets in this video. Let's imagine on April 12, Sharon did 7 hours on the Kirschbaum Southwoods Road job. From the main menu, click Customers, Enter Time, Use Weekly Timesheets. Now we have to bring the date forward to April 12. When we click April 12, we get the week of April 10 to April 16. Then when we choose Sharon, we see that she has already accumulated time for a different job during that week. So we have to click on the next available row and choose the job that she did. Then we have to click in the day that she did it, and we type in 7, because I believe the instruction said, yes, 7 hours on the Kirschbaum job. Now this is not billable, so we will remove the check mark and just leave 7 hours, and we can click in the notes field. Now even though you cannot see all of the notes, you can still type in just as much as you could type in on the time slip. And you could say, Southwoods Road is very dangerous, or whatever other relevant information you think you need. After we click Save and Close, we can see the result in the report. Sharon now has 2 different jobs that she worked on. She worked 6 hours on the Brown job and 7 hours on the Kirschbaum job. Now, unfortunately, if you double-click right there on the number, you will not go back to the time sheet. You will instead go back to the individual activity. And if you need to see the time sheet from there, you can click time sheet and go back to the timesheet that you recorded the information that showed up on this report. Also notice if you go time by job, you see now Kirschbaum now has billable staff time for Ben and no item assigned and not billable for Sharon. This report organizes the same time that's recorded in a different way. Now let's try a billable item of time. Imagine on April 13, Ben did 9 hours on the Hanson Place job and it's billable to Hanson. From the main menu, click Customers, enter time, use weekly timesheet. The date that we're recording is April 13. Notice the entire week comes up, and then when we choose Ben, we see he already has billable time during that week for a different job. On the next available row, we click here and choose the Hanson Place job. Now this time we're going to bill Ben, and the item we're going to choose is billable staff time. And he did 9 hours on the 13th. And of course we leave the default set, which is marked as billable. Of course you should add some notes. Hanson Place job was nice, or whatever information you think is relevant, but it's marked as billable. Now when we click save and close, we can open up the time by name report and we can see Ben now has 2 jobs that he's listed on and the number of hours that he actually worked. We can collapse this list by clicking the triangle for both workers, and then you'll get a simple summary of all the hours that the workers worked. If you open the time by job detail, you can see that the Hanson Place job now has Ben the worker as unbilled and Sharon the worker as not billable, and a list of all the different work items and all of the different events under Brown for Hanson, as well as all of the different items that were worked for Kirschbaum. And now let's bill Brown for Ben's time. Let's imagine on April 14, we billed Brown Company for the Hanson Place job, specifically for Ben's hours that he worked the day before on April 13th, and we bill him at the rate of $44 per hour. We open the invoice window from the icon bar and move the date forward to April 14th. When we choose Brown Company Hanson Place, we get the available estimate. Now we could choose the estimate, fill up the invoice with what remains on the estimate, and then put Ben's hours at the bottom. But it might be easier and more clear if we make a separate invoice for this, which sometimes you are allowed to do. So we will choose the billable time and cost, and when we click OK, we do see that there's one item of time that's billable to the Hanson Place job. We click the check mark in the margin and click OK. Remember, we already learned about this message and we're not worried about it. So we again click OK, and we notice the 9 hours have been placed on the invoice for the work that Ben did. On the invoice itself, we put the rate that we're billing him out at, push tab, and now we can bill Hanson Place for $396 for the 9 hours that Ben did on April 14th. When we click save and close, oops, don't worry about this default here, click save and close, ignore the spelling, we can open the profit and loss by job, and you can see income from billed time has increased on the Hanson Place job. Income from billed time is the $396. We can double click and go right back to the invoice and edit the invoice, and the results on the reports will change immediately.